be learning about the metabolism of phenylalanine and tyrosine. So, phenylalanine and tyrosine are derivative of aromatic amino acids. Phenylalanine is an essential amino acid, and tyrosine is non-essential. Phenylalanine is readily converted to tyrosine, but reaction is reversible. The predominant metabolism of phenylalanine occurs through tyrosine. During the course of degradation, phenylalanine and tyrosine are converted to metabolize, which can serve as a precursor for the synthesis of glucose and fat. And these amino acids are both glucogenic and ketogenic. The metabolic fate includes the two steps, the conversion of phenylalanine to tyrosine and metabolic fate of tyrosine. First, the conversion of phenylalanine to tyrosine, degradation of phenylalanine occurs through tyrosine. Phenylalanine is hydroxylated at 10 position by phenylalanine hydroxylase to produce tyrosine. This is an irreversible reaction which requires the participation of specific coenzyme. Bioptyrin, which is structurally related to solate, the active form of bioptyrin is tetrahydrobiopterin. In the phenylalanine hydroxylase reaction, tetrahydrobiopterin oxidizes to dihydrobiopterin. Tetrahydrobiopterin is regenerated by an NADPH-dependent dihydrobiopterin reductase. This enzyme is present in liver. Degradation of tyrosine. As phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine as a single pathway, it is responsible for both these amino acids which occur mostly in liver. In sequence of reaction, tyrosine is converted to fumarate and acetoacetate. Tyrosine first undergoes transamination and to give para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate. The conversion to tyrosine to para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate, which is also known as PHPP. This reaction is catalyzed by tyrosine alpha-ketoglutarate transaminase, which required beta V6 and ascorbic acid. Second step is conversion of para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate to homogenticate. Para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate hydroxylase or dioxygen enzyme is responsible for this reaction. It is copper-containing enzyme. It catalyzes oxidative decarboxylation and hydroxylation of the phenyl ring of the substrate to produce homogenticase. This reaction involves shifting the hydroxyl group from para position to meta and incorporate a new hydroxyl group at para position. The reaction is as follows. The phenylalanine, in the presence of phenylalanine hydroxylase, changes to tyrosine. The tyrosine aminase changes the tyrosine to para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate. The para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate deoxygenase changes the para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate to homogenticase. This homogenticase changes into 4-methyl acetoacetate in the presence of homogenticate oxidase. Then this 4-methyl acetoacetate changes to methyl acetoacetate, 4-fumaryl acetoacetate in the presence of methyl acetoacetate isomerase. This 4-fumaryl acetoacetate changes to fumarate and acetoacetate in the presence of fumaryl acetoacetate hydrolysis. This fumarate either goes into TC cycle or forms of glucose, or the acetoacetate changes into fat. Then there is a reaction, phenylalanine changes into tyrosine, the phenylalanine hydroxylase, water, oxygen changes to water. Then this tetrahydrobiopterin to dihydrobiopterin are the same, and this NADPH plus H plus changes to NADP plus. The conversion of homogenticate to methyl acetoacetate, homogenticate oxidase, and then iron-containing metalloenzyme is responsible for the reaction which cleaves the benzene ring of hydrogen to form 4-methyl acetoacetate. The conversion of methyl acetoacetate to fumaryl acetoacetate, in this step, isomerization of methyl acetoacetate takes place in the presence of isomerase. Hydrolysis of free fatty acid is catalyzed by enzyme free fatty acetate, which brings the hydrolysis of fumaryl acetoacetate to liberate fumarate and acetoacetate. Thank you.